ito ngayon para bubutasan ko po. Marami po mga butas doon sa mga statements ni Mayor Go. Hopefully, I have some few questions na kailangan niya masagot. Kapag hindi niya masagot, doon makikita na meron po siya talagang itinatago. Hindi po kapanipaniwala, marami din po ako, Madam Chair, na request sa committee na ito ipapatawag. Unang-una, ipapatawag po natin ay yung pong midwife na nagpaanak sa kanya. Pangalawa po, nung magpa-file siya ng late registration, sino po doon kung saan siya nag-file ng late registration ang tumanggap. Pangatlo po, Madam Chair, gusto ko pong patawag yung barangay chairman na kung saan nandun yung kanyang farm. Kasi syempre, if you have a farm and it's not a backyard farm, it's a commercial farm, you need to get a permit para ma-aprubahan yung farm na yon. You have to get a sanitation permit, etc. Nais ko rin pong patawag yung mayor na nag-endorse sa kanya, na nag-last term na, and she was endorsed by that mayor to take his place. So, syempre, si Mayor, I'm sure, hindi naman siguro niya endorse itong si Mayor Go kung hindi niya kakilala. Patatawag din po natin yung BIR. Patatawag din po natin yung mga suki niya na pinagbibenta niya ng baboy. Patatawag din po natin yung mga tauhan niya sa farm. Kasi sabi niya, lumaki siya sa farm and she worked there for so many years or managed the farm for so many years. And of course, hindi naman niya pwede i-manage yung isang commercial farm all by herself. She has to have a lot of people. And who are those people? Hindi naman pwedeng sasabihin niya, hindi ko kilala yung mga taong yun. And of course, dapat marunong siya magkapampangan. Matanong ko lang muna, Mayor Go, marunong ka magkapampangan?
Magandang umaga po, Senator Rafi. Madam Chairman, Senwin, di taklamo po yung aking kapampangan po.
Hindi klaro.
Hindi po. Konti lang po yung alam ko po. Konti lang po.
Okay. Yun nga yun eh. Matagal ka sa Tarlac at nakahalubilo mo yung mga tauhan mo and all of these people that work under you, of course, they speak Kapampangan. And I'll tell you, I lived in Zamboanga only for 2 years, from kinder to grade 1, and yet, natuto ako magsalita ng Chabacano. And it's unbelievable on your part, and you live in that place up to now, and dealing with people, with your staff sa farm mo, at hindi ka natutong magkapampangan, konti lang, ako malawak ang Chabacano ko. And I only live in Zamboanga for 2 years. At a very early age, in your case, from start hanggang ngayon, nasa Tarlac ka na ang isa primary language doon ay Kapampangan, and yet konti lang. That's unbelievable. That's very amusing. Tell it to the Marines, sabi pa nga nila. So mamaya po, Madam Chair,
yes,
marami akong katanungan na sigurado kong pagpapawisan itong si Mayor Go. Bigyan po natin siya ng tissue at saka panyo. Maraming salamat po, Madam Chair.
Salamat, Sen. Rafi. And at the proper time, bago tayo mag-suspend ng hearing mamaya, iimbita nga ng chair sa ating COMSEC yung mga dagdag na resource persons mula po sa private sector, mula sa local government, sa mga national government agencies din. Para dun sa nais itanong mamaya at sa tumanggap ng late registration ni Mayor, we actually have here in the hearing today and can be questioned also later yung local civil registrar po ng Tarlac. So salamat po sa opening statement. COMSEC, paki-acknowledge yung ating mga resource persons at pasumpain yung mga hindi pa nanumpa nung nakaraan.
Good morning, everyone. The committee would like to acknowledge the presence of the following resource person. From the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, we have Undersecretary Gilberto Cruz, together with Director Winnie Gidato and Dr. Winston John Castro. From the Department of Labor and Employment, we have Mr. Jerome Lucas, Attorney Margaret Lapid-Pule, Attorney Diane Corrine Ramos. From the Department of Foreign Affairs, we have Von Ryan Pangwi. From the Interagency Council Against Trafficking, we have Attorney Hannah Lizette Manalili. From the Philippine Statistics Office Authority, we have Engineer Marisa Grande, Attorney Eliezer Ambatali. Then from the Commission on Immigration, we have Attorney Arvin Cesar Santos, Attorney Jose Carlitos Licas, Mr. Peter Demotenis Demetria. Then from the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, we have Retired General Raul Villanueva, Attorney Jess Amaris Fernandez. Then from the National Bureau of Investigation, we have Agent Marvin Gangano and R.D. Jerry Abiera. Then from the Philippine National Police, we have Chief Investigation Division Police Colonel Crispin Banes. Then we have Police Major Ja Berong. Then from the Philippine National Police, we have Acting Area Police Commander of Northern Luzon, Major General Romeo Carama Jr. Then we have Police Brigadier General Jose Higaldo Jr., the Regional Director. Then we have from the Municipality Ambabban, Province of Tarlac, we have Mayor Alice Buo. Then from the Land Registration Authority, we have Attorney Ronnie Tababa. From the Tarlac Electric Cooperative Incorporation, we have Mr. Jesus Bruno. Then from the Commission on Election, we have Chairperson George Irwin Garcia. From the Clark Development Corporation, we have Bison and Attorney Richard Chan. We have the Municipal Assessor of Bamban Tarlac. We have Mr. Mar Antonio Tan. And we have the Civil Registrar, Local Civil Registry of Tarlac. We have Mr. Armin Leonardo Ibarra. Madam Chair, we invited Mr. Walter Wong Long, then the General Manager of Sung Yuan Technology, but he's currently detained at the Provincial Jail of Tarlac under the jurisdiction of the Province of Tarlac, manned by Warden Police Colonel Samuel B. Munoz. The committee wrote a letter requesting Warden Munoz to allow Mr. Walter Wong Long to appear on this committee in due time to the time due to time constraint. Further, be informed that movement of PDL outside the jail premises requires a court order, as this entails a lot of papers, paperwork to be submitted to the provincial government for the approval. In connection, the undersigned manifests and apologizes for the non-compliance on her part and has no intention to undermine the Senate's inherent power, but also consider the court's contempt if we will break the rules. Rest assured that we will comply if the honorable body will issue same order. The committee staff also went to Tarlac to deliver the invitation to the incorporators of Baofu, Mr. Chang Ruin, Bayung Lin, and Mr. Shang Wan. The invitation was received by the head of the security, Mr. Jimmy Alputan of Pontana, and another incorporator, Ms. Rachel John Malonzo Carrion. The invitation was received by her mother, Ms. Lloyda Carrion. We also invited the incorporators of Hongxin, Ms. Rowena Gonzalez Evangelista, but the address therein are non-existent. Ms. Rita Itoralde, the corporate secretary of Hongxin, do not live in that address. The invitation for Ms. Joy Castro was received by her nephew, Brian Butin, and Ms. Thelma Naranan. The president and treasurer of Hongxin do not live in that address. That's all for now, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Comsec. Please extend the committee's appreciation to the warden of the provincial jail where Mr. Walter Wong Long is a person deprived of liberty. Of course, ginagalang naman natin yung